Today, I want to show you some fun, funky, geometric designs that you can put together, circles and squares, so I want to show you how you can free motion quilt those on your projects. Hi, I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst of Chatterbox Quilts, and today we're going to be doing some more free motion quilting, working with some geometric shapes. So before we actually start stitching them though, it's best to draw them out so you understand how the designs are made. So I'm going to show you how to do that on the whiteboard. Now before you get stitching your circles and squares, it's a good idea to draw them out so you know how the design is formed and where you're going to go next with it when you start stitching. So what I like to do is to alternate the squares and the circles. So we're going to start with a square. You can start anywhere in the square, if you will, but this design is formed to the inside. So your first stitching is actually setting the boundary of that square. And then you start going inside, and you can have, you know, relatively the same spacing between the lines. You can have really different spacing between the lines, but eventually you'll come to the center and, you know, well, you really can't go any further. So then you need to get out of the square. So I like to go up on a diagonal. I don't always do that, but I can. And then we're going to go over and form the circle. So the circle, unlike the square, is formed towards the outside. So you've got your circle, and you want to make sure you leave enough space between the square, because the next circle is going to get bigger, and then we're going to get bigger. We're going to do about three of them, okay? And then, of course, you have to move to the next square. And again, you've got to leave your space, because remember, we're forming that perimeter of the square with that first stitching. So you need to go way over before you start stitching your square. And then you're going to come down and you're going to form it again. Now, when you want to come out of the square, you don't have to come out on a diagonal. You could come straight across and then start doing your next circle if you wanted to. And I've got these going in a line, but you don't have to make them in a line. Let's start with a circle this time. And we're going to circle the circle and circle the circle that circled the circle. And then we're going to come off in whatever direction we want, and we're going to start with that square. And remember to go further over to leave that space, because you're building the square inside, but that first stitching is the perimeter, it's the outside. And then you can come over. Now, you don't have to do another circle. You don't have to alternate them if you don't want to, and you don't have to do a square. I'm going to be really bold and do a rectangle, okay? So there's lots of different things you can do with these designs. And the circles don't have to be huge either. You can make them smaller or bigger than the square, whatever you want to do. But you can see how easy it is to fill in your quilt doing these designs. So come out on whatever angle you want, put in whatever you want next, a circle or a square or a rectangle, whatever you want to do. But the nice thing about this design is that you can make it different sizes. And because you can make it different sizes, it gives a lot of variety, and it also makes it really easy to do as an all-over design and fill up your quilt really quickly by making the designs big. Okay, so I suggest you practice this on paper or whiteboard, whatever you have. And when you start feeling comfortable with it and you feel like you're ready to get it down on fabric, let's go to the machine and let's start stitching it out. Now, before we get stitching, if you don't know how to set up your sewing machine for free motion quilting, look in the description below, because I put links to some videos that will help you do that. All right, so let's start, as we always do, by getting our bobbin thread up to the top and locking our stitches so our stitching doesn't fall apart later on. Okay, so we're doing circles and squares, and I'm going to start with, well, let's start with a square, okay? I'm going to link these together to start. Okay, so they don't have to be even spacing between the lines here. This is kind of a wonky, fun design, so don't worry if they're not. And then to carry on to the circle, I'm actually going to go, I can either go sideways or I'm going to go out on a diagonal to start the next design. All right, so I need to leave myself space because I'm going to do that circle three times, right? So I need to make sure I go over far enough because I'm going to be going around it two more times and I don't want to run into my square. All right, So I've got my square, I've got my circle. Now, the circle can be the same size as the square, or it could be smaller or bigger, whatever you want to do. But what I like to do is to alternate them. So I've got my square, my circle, I'm going to go to a square next, right? And depending on where you want to start your square, I'm going to start my square here and move back. So I need to make sure I'm far enough over, remember, so that I don't run into my circle. So that first stitching is setting that boundary, okay? So my square is now building inside as opposed to my circle, which built outside. All right, so now I'm ready to move on to my circle again. Right, so I could just keep doing that, moving it along. But there's other things you can do with this design too, of course. If you don't want to make it linear like this, you can certainly make it go in all different directions. So let's be different this time. Let's start with one of our circles and see what we can do in a non-linear fashion, as it were. Right, so there's my circle done. Now I'm going to move off a different angle. And again, I'm moving far away because I'm building my square inside rather than outside. So we're setting that perimeter of the square first. Okay, and now I have to decide where I'm going to go with my square because I don't have to go off in a diagonal. I can go straight down if I want to, and then maybe I might want to do another square. You know, I can mix up a bit, right? Or how about a rectangle? So while I say squares, it can be, you know, if it's longer, a longer square, it's actually a rectangle, right? And then we can do some more circles. Okay, so I'm just going to stop here. Can see what that looks like. So you can move this across a quilt. It doesn't have to be linear. If it's linear, it works really well in borders or sashing, but you can just move it all over the place, alternating the circles and squares or not. You can make your circles bigger or smaller, your squares more like a rectangle than a square. You can do all those things. So lots of different opportunities mixing up circles and squares in your quilting. Thanks for watching today. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your quilting friends. And remember to subscribe and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I release a new video. I've also got suggested videos for you here that you might find helpful. And for more free quilting information, be sure to go to my website at www.chatterboxquilts.com.